You know, the majority of us as Ugandans, we use biomass or we use charcoal, we use firewood.
According to statistics from the Ministry of Energy, biomass accounts for about 90% of energy consumption in the country. Firewood accounts for 80%. Charcoal and crop residue make up another 10%, while electric power, by contrast, only accounts for 1.4% of the national energy balance. It is evident that high dependence on biomass has negatively impacted the climate. Now, stakeholders in the energy sector are calling for a transition towards clean, renewable energy.
The more we release harmful gases into the atmosphere, the more we cause a change on our climate on the negative side. So the many changes that we have been seeing in our rain patterns, on the increasing disasters in this country, is an impact of the changes in our climate.
So that's a big challenge. So investment in those technologies that would improve the efficiency and the conservation of energy, renewable energy, is very important.
They recommend that government makes solar a viable alternative to hydropower and biomass.
If government could consider, waiving taxes on everything that goes along with the solar cooking, for example, and this goes for even the other products, for irrigation, for lighting.
We are trying to develop our solar. Uganda is geographically positioned very well, where we have the equator passing through Uganda, and we have the capacity of solar energy of 5.4 kilowatts per square meter per day.
Nankabirwa further discloses that with the right policies and infrastructures, Uganda can become a continental hub for renewable energy.
Once government has policies in place, development partners will rush. The banks are now shifting from investing in petroleum to investing in renewable energy.
Meanwhile, the Minister of Energy also launched the National Renewable Energy Platform. Uganda has a renewable energy production potential of about 5,300 megawatts. Rachel Nashwala reporting for the news.